Hi everyone, this is Atik. I welcome all of you to my channel Engineering Drive. Hope you are all fine. Today I am going to continue the concepts of computer organization, and I am going to specifically show you one difference between the two commonly used words in computer organization. They are multiprocessors and multicomputers. Okay, I believe that without the difference between these two, it is unfair to continue the next concepts of computer organization. Okay, and the questions, simple questions from these topics has been appeared and asked in many competitive exams. And many of the people, they will get confused. What type of questions can be framed from this topic? Everything I am going to discuss in my today's video. That is, what is a multiprocessor computer and what is a multi-computers? The difference between them. My dear students, I will ask you one question. Suppose I am a user of computer. I want to increase the performance of my system. I want to increase the speed of my computer. Then what I can do now? What are the options available for me? I want to increase the speed of the computer. Why a person want to increase the speed of the computer? If a person want to do the work fast. Simple answer. I want to complete my work in a less amount of time. Then to complete my work in a less amount of time, I need my computer to work very fast. Then what I can do now? I want to complete my work in less amount of time. What I can do? So I can have two options. I can use any of those two options. Either I can have a computer with multiprocessor capability, or if I don't have a computer with multiprocessor capability, then I can go for second option, that is multi-computers. So what is mean by multiprocessor? What is mean by multi-computers? We need to understand first. Multi means, we know that many. Okay. More than two can be referred as multi. Okay. Multiprocessors, which means we are talking about here a single computer. Carefully everyone, you listen. Multiprocessor system means here single computer with many processors. So let me draw one simple diagram to you. For you, this is a, let us take, this is my computer. In this computer, what I will do? CPU 1, CPU 2, CPU 3. Okay. Only one computer. This is a single computer. This is single personal computer. And in this personal computer, I am having how many processors? For my simplicity, I have taken three processors. CPU 1, CPU 2 and CPU 3. So, can I call it as a multiprocessor system? Yes. A computer with more than two processors, or a computer with many processors, can be termed as multiprocessor system. Okay. So in multiprocessors, if I use multiple CPUs, then what happen? Of course, the work that I want to do on my computer can be done very fast, and I can complete the work in less amount of time. So this is a multiprocessor system. Okay. So single computer, three CPUs, no problem. What about memory? Whether CPU 1 will have separate memory, whether CPU 2 will have separate memory, or CPU 3 will have separate memory? The answer is no. All these three CPUs, they will share common memory. Okay, let us say this is a memory, main memory. This is our memory. So our compute, our processors, they won't have separate memory to access the data. CPU 1 will use the same memory, CPU 2 also will use the same memory, and even CPU 3 also will have used the same memory. That's why we call this multiprocessor systems as shared memory systems. So we call this multiprocessor multiprocessor computers or multiprocessor systems with another name. They are known as shared memory systems. Okay, this is very, very important point. So a multiprocessor computer or a multiprocessor system is a system in which a computer will have multiple CPUs. And even though a computer will have multiple CPUs, all the CPUs or all the processors will access the same memory. That's why we call them as shared memory systems. Okay, this is about multiprocessor system. This is one way I can increase the speed and functionality of my computer. What is another way? Another way is I can make use of multi-computers concept. What is a multi-computer? Just if we concentrate on siding, there only we'll get the answer. In multiprocessor, we have used multiple CPUs in single computer. One more option is, suppose you can't do this one, then you can achieve the speed by using multi-computers. Multi-computers means separate computers. Let us say this is PC1, this is PC2, and this is PC3. Let us say three computers. What I can do? I can take multiple computers and I can connect them. Okay, for our simplicity, I have taken the example of monitor picture. Okay, actually these are not monitors, these are computers. Example, PC1, PC2, PC3. You can connect three computers and you can increase the functionality and speed of the computer. Yes or no? A single computer can do limited amount of work. So what I am doing here, I am adding extra two computers, and this forms a network of computers. We can call this one as multi-computers. Okay, this is, in this way I can increase the speed. The next question is, sir, in multiprocessor system, all the CPUs or all the processors, they have shared same memory. What about multi-computers? In multi-computers, every computer will have separate memory. M1 belongs to only PC1, memory 2, M2 belongs to only PC2, memory M3 belongs to only PC3, which means every computer will have its own memory. PC1 will have its own memory M1, PC2 will have its own memory M2, PC3 will have the same memory M3, which means all the individual computers, they have their own memories. Okay, then the thing is, how they will communicate with each other? Now here all the processors are communicating with each other. How it is possible? Because they are sharing the same memory, that's why they are able to communicate with each other. But how these individual computers communicate with each other? They will communicate with each other with the help of messages. How they will communicate with each other? With the help of messages. That's why another name of this multi-computer systems is message passing systems. So another name of this multi-computers is message passing systems, because in multi-computers, one computer communicate with another computer to increase the speed with the help of messages. That's why we call them as message passing systems. Another name of multiprocessor system is shared memory systems. And one more alternate name of multi-computers is message passing systems. In exam, how they can ask the questions to you in bits means, simply they will ask you, which of the following method employs the concept of message passing system. Then at that time they will give the option multiprocessor, multi-computer, C some other option, D some other option. At that time you need to give the option multi-computers, because multi-computers only will implement message passing. One more way they will ask the question to you in bits is, in multiprocessor system, all the CPUs, whether they will share the memory or they will have their individual memories. So if you know the proper answer, then we can easily able to predict the particular bit. How? All the processors, they will share the same memory. Okay, and they will give the bits like this also. In which of the following types of systems shared memory concept is employed? Okay, which of the following systems shared memory concept is employed? So at that time they will give the option multiprocessors, multi-computers, or they will give some other types of computer, then you need to write the answer as multi-processor system. So both these concepts are used to increase the speed of our computer. Okay, hopefully the difference between multiprocessors and multi-computers has been clear to you. Okay, so with this, let me close my today's session of video. See you soon. Take care. Allah Hafiz.